Good morning to all of you. Today I am presenting my research work on potential of cesium cumini as anti-inflammatory agent. We know that inflammation is a reaction of living tissues to injury, infection or irritation. This is happened because of lysosomal enzymes released during inflammation produce a variety of disorders. HRBC is an analogous to the lysosomal membrane, and hence stabilization of HRBC by hypotonicity induced membrane lysis taken as an in vitro measure of anti-inflammatory activity. Here we use the plant cesium cumini, belongs to the family Myrtaceae. According to our knowledge, anti-inflammatory activity of hydroalcohol extracts of fruit juice and pulp of cesium cumini is not evaluated so far. This is the method of extraction of the cesium cumini extracts, and we use the protocol as mentioned by Fonse et al. 2012. First we collect the blood, then we add 2 ml of sterilized elsewhere solution, centrifuge at 3000 rpm, then we collect the pellet, that is of the cells, prepare the 10% RBC suspension, and we use for the assay. We use extract plus 1 ml PBS, 2 ml hyposaline and 0.5 ml HRBC suspension. All these mixture together and incubated at 37 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes, centrifuge it, and then we take OD of this solution at 560 nanometer. For the control we use DW, and overall all the collected data is analyzed by using ANOVA statistical tool. These are the reference. These are the result of the study. Among all test extracts, JPF 100 at 100 microgram per ml was most potent. High concentration, that is at 200 microgram per ml of JJR and JPF, were less effective as compared to low concentration of extract. The JJR and JPF extract exhibited membrane stabilization activity is not dose dependent. This may indicate that the activity is enzymatic, hence substrate concentration is responsible at the 100 and 200 microgram per ml. However, it is interesting to note that the standard is a pure compound, whereas the all extracts contains complex of active ingredients. Therefore, it is noteworthy that purification of active principle from extracts will probably enhance the membrane stabilization activity than standard. Our results are in concord with the results of Jain et al. In 2010, Roy et al. In 2011 and Ajiboy et al. 2018. They all work on this. Only the difference is that they use leaves of this plant, and in present study we use fruit pulp. So finally, we conclude that in present study, cesium cumini showed significant anti-inflammatory activity in vitro, which could partly contribute to ethnomedical use of plants. However, further investigation is required for isolation, and its mode of action is suggested for the development of a new drug in the treatment of control of inflammation in general. It is well understood that the rich diversity of forest and field biota provides a fruitful source for the discovery of life-saving drugs. These are the references. Thank you for the organizers to give such a wonderful opportunity for the online presentation. Thank you.